Hello, this is Tom from Floppy Deep Dives and doing something a little bit different tonight. Instead of posting, I am going to make a quick little video just to show you something that I came across that I thought was interesting and kind of funny, but see what you think about it. So basically, if you never heard of Floppy Deep Dives before, I go and I'm going through my wares, my different floppies that I've collected from when I was a kid back in the 80s. And I'm going case by case of the different floppies that I have and sharing the different games, utilities, or whatever else I find on there. And then basically to bring back memories, childhood memories, or share memories that I had and maybe that you had doing these different, collecting these different Commodore programs as kids. And now having the fun of loading them up 30 years later and doing it again. So anyway, here on the screen, my next floppy deep dive, I am going to be doing a utilities disk. And on this utilities disk, as you can see, there's quite a few programs. I usually start at the bottom. And I'm going to do this first ultimate utility here. So I bring up this ultimate utility and run it. And you can see right here on the master menu the different things that this utility is supposed to do. It's the ultimate utility. So you can copy a complete disk, transfer a cartridge ROM to a disk, or transfer disk to a cartridge ROM. So stuff I've never seen before on a ultimate utility, but a little bit different, and see the different things that it can do. Now on the next page we're going to look at, it could also see number 4, run Apple software, or number 5, run IBM software. So doing a lot of different things potentially that this ultimate software can do for you. And then on page 3, 20 more items of different things that it supposedly can do for you. And I like number 12 there, the modem baud rate doubler. So I could go from my 1200 to 24 automatically with this ultimate utility. So anyway, we'll hit return and go to the next page, and that's it. We got 3 pages of 20 different items that it all can do for you. I'm going to do the real basic one, the copy complete disk, to see exactly what this can do for me. And when I open it up, it tells me to wait, and then it comes up with this message. Complete disk deleted, memory clear, done, and it does an automatic reset. So basically, just completely wiping out, and let's see what it did to my floppy. And as you can see, basically formatted my floppy. So I believe I have come across the first Trojan in my collection of Commodore 64, and it's kind of funny, someone mentioned in one of the comments that be careful when you're doing your floppy deep dives, you might come across a Trojan, and then said, no, it's a Commodore 64, there's not, what was I thinking? So well before the internet, there were Trojans for the Commodore 64. Just so you could, you know, this basically is emulating that it formatted my disk. It didn't truly do it. If I go back here and show you and just do a reset, the floppy is still completely intact. It didn't do it, but sure, it was just a little joke, but I think it was the beginning of Trojans and doing different things that could really scare a kid back in the 80s if they had something good on there, some game that 300 baud took all night to download and hope no one would pick up the phone so it would drop that connection. So it would definitely make your heart skip a beat or two. So anyone else know of any Trojans for the Commodore 64? I believe this is the first one that I have found and thought it was interesting enough to make a video. I hope you liked it. Please share any comments that you have, and I hope you would like this and going more in the direction of doing floppy deep dives as a video instead of just typing long posts out and posting pictures, and hopefully y'all will like that too. Until next time, y'all have a wonderful evening, and see you at the next floppy deep dive.